Yes, products like this in reactions involving a mixture of similar compounds. Products like this, I mean, there would be better reactions, there would be much better opportunities to talk and know about these type of products. But because we are yet to go into any of those processes, let this be the first time where we are talking of a product which has come from two different molecules, both of them capable of showing the reaction of its own, and both of them are involved together in the formation of this molecule. In other terms, this has come out of a mechanism involving both these molecules. Now such products are called, again, can any of you call say this, what are such products called? Alright, as I said, there would be better examples, better reactions, we would want to talk about them. For the time being, these products are called crossover products. These products are called crossover products. Realize, in different reactions, by crossover products, we would be referring to those products which would have come out of an interaction of two different molecules of similar type. But they are different molecules of similar type because both are diols, both are capable of giving this reaction. So I'm working with a mixture of this. This is going to be my expected crossover product. Now there would be reactions where crossover products would be obtained. And there would be reactions where crossover products will not be obtained. Fine. But whenever I use this term crossover product, you should understand that I'm talking of a product which is involving both the molecules or both the compounds which are similar. Take down. In pinacol pinacolone, using a mixture of diols, in pinacol pinacolone using a mixture of diols, no crossover product is obtained. In pinacol pinacolone using a mixture of diols, no crossover product is obtained. Again, it would be a little too early to start expecting you people to relate to all of this. Still, any of you, in a case if you don't have a crossover product, I repeat, reactions, as I said, there would be reactions where you'll find crossover products, there would be reactions where you'll have no crossover products, and we'll see very soon that verifying this would help us in knowing the reaction mechanism better. If suppose you do not have a crossover product, what would you interpret? Very true. A crossover product would certainly require intermolecular interaction. So whenever you don't have a crossover product, this means that you're having pinacol pinacolone on different types of molecules independently. You're having this rearrangement on different molecules independently. The presence of other molecule of similar type is not having any effect. There is no crossover product. Iska alkyl group isme nahi aa raha hai. Iska matlab it's not an intermolecular business. All of this is intramolecular. Whenever you don't have a crossover product, you will interpret that the mechanism is intramolecular. Molecule ke andar ka baat hai. दो मॉलिक्यूल के बीच में इंटरेक्शन नहीं हो रहा है, इंटरमॉलिक्यूलर नहीं हो रहा है, ठीक है? एंड वंस यू नो इट्स इंट्रामॉलिक्यूलर, व्हाट मोर कैन यू इंटरप्रेट अबाउट दिस, अबाउट द मैकेनिज्म? यस Yes, a little louder.
Shapes are possible only in adjacent
carbons. But it's adjacent carbons only in any of the products. Even in crossover products, it's adjacent carbon. I'm not talking of adjacent carbons. I'm talking of it being intramolecular. Fine, adjacent carbons of the same molecule. That's true. That's true. What else do you confer? Acha, what could have prevented in a mechanism like this? What could have prevented? Realize, iska bhi ek carbocation yahan par ban jata, iska bhi ek carbocation yahan par ban jata. Let me do that. Let me have H plus acting on both of them. Let me have a carbocation formed here. Let me have a carbocation formed here. What could have prevented this coming here or that going there? What could have prohibited that? But that was a reaction which was diazotization. It was not pinacol, it was diazotization in cases of amines only. He's trying to explain it in a way. He's saying that this step is very short-lived, this is very unstable, this is going to rush into the more stable structure. Now, because it's going to rush into the more stable structure, it will very quickly occur. But there is a difference between occurring quickly and occurring intramolecular only. Amazing, very true. This can occur only if these two processes, loss of water and this migration, is occurring together. Such intramolecular mechanisms with no crossover product. Such intramolecular mechanisms with no crossover products would make you feel that loss of water and movement of alkyl group are occurring together. In the sense, although I'm talking of a carbocation like this involving a shift and again becoming a more stable carbocation, to some extent now what you said is also true. Because if these two steps occur together, this would mean that this has a very, very short life. That's also true. This has a very, very short life. In the sense, there are theories, ideas which advocate that there is a three-membered ring formation as a transitory state, where as this group moves out, you know, it's going to move out as water. So don't take this as OH minus going out, you know it's going to be water going out. I'm just skipping that step. But this going out as water and this methyl migrating are occurring almost simultaneously, involving a three-membered transitory state, So obviously, as this bond is about to move, as it is going out, this bond is subsequently being formed. There is no possibility of this going to the other molecule. In other words, in the transitory state, formation of this bond will also propel loss of water. Although it will never mean that water needs a reason to go out. Water is a very good leaving group, true. But because of the observations, I would say that it's always intramolecular and this is possible. Iska alkyl wahan pe kabhi nahi ja raha hai, uska alkyl yahan pe kabhi nahi aa raha hai. It's all within the molecule. Intramolecular means the formation of this carbocation and the migration are very rapid processes. In other words, they're occurring together. Fair enough. We can move on. Now, whenever it occurs in this way, intramolecular, subsequent steps, when it comes to a molecule which is chiral, suppose, although right now I will not want to go too much into it, but again for the sake of it, this is again a result of such phenomena. One result, you know, is no crossover product. Another result is, if there is chirality around this group, you understand, chirality is about arrangement of the different groups, arrangement of the different groups. So if this carbon is the one which is chiral, so it's not CH3 for the reason, it's suppose CABC, and this is another group, which is going to become another group. Instead of CH3, if suppose this is CABC, having three different groups, if there is chirality around this carbon. Now do you realize that a carbon which has three different groups, it has three different groups, and this is certainly a fourth different group, would be optically active? Would be optically active? And how would its optical activity change? How would its optical nature change? Its optical nature would change if the position of this fourth group with respect to these three groups become different. Its optical nature can change only if its attachment or its orientation with the fourth group, which supposes the molecule, this chain in this case, only if the position of this is different with respect to the existing other three different groups, the optical activity could change. But if it's occurring in a way like this, intramolecular, this is going out simultaneously, this is being formed, then with respect to those three different groups, the position of this would remain intact. Now, had this got a little more liberty, had it been allowed to move from this molecule to that molecule, then there could have been a difference in structures encountered. This would have attached itself maybe to some other molecule with a little difference in the existing or the initial configuration or arrangement of atoms. But while this is being done, if it's through a three-membered cyclic transitory state, if the steps are occurring together, it will not get an opportunity to have its structure changed. In other words, if this happens to be a chiral carbon, its chirality will be retained. Its chirality will be retained. With respect to those three groups, now I repeat, with respect to those three groups, I'm not talking of CH3, I'm talking of CABC. With respect to those three groups, this bonding and this bonding will not be a difference, provided this migration is occurring quickly in the same step through a mechanism like this. So two results: one, no crossover product; two, chirality around this carbon retained. Now, this chirality part, realize any change in the chirality. See, it's always going to be four different groups. If these are ABC, it's always going to be four different groups. It's going to be chiral, it's going to reflect right, left or right with certain degree. Now, if that degree of rotation remains constant with respect to this carbon, then you would see that the chirality is retained. Now, realize the chirality or its particular structure, this is suppose the group which is attached to this chain. Now obviously, if its position is varied, if its position is changing with respect to other groups, then it would bring in a difference in its optical nature. If it executes a mechanism like this, intramolecular, then with respect to the other three groups, the structure or the orientation of this would remain the same. I'm not talking about the entire molecule. Obviously, the molecule is changing. From this molecule, it's becoming a different molecule. So I'm not saying that its optical nature would remain the same, but around this carbon, which is a chiral carbon, the arrangement of groups would remain the same.
Around the carbon, which
is attached to this carbon having OH. So if this is chiral around here, then its chirality would be retained. I'm talking of this carbon. This is why I'm repeating so many times, it's not CH3, it's CABC. Fine.
So the molecule should be symmetrical.
So the molecule should be
symmetrical.
Can't say symmetrical.
Sir, complete symmetry, because instead of it's moving on to the right hand side, if the position is not changing, that means both of the carbon.
You're saying that this molecule itself is symmetrical, no?
Yes.
That is true. This molecule is symmetrical. But let me explain this again. There would be no crossover products, And if the carbon happens to be chiral, the arrangement of groups around it would remain intact. Fine. All of that would point or suggest to an intramolecular mechanism like this. We should move on now. To the various common cases. Now, let me give you few very basic structures to begin with, and we'll start with symmetrical structures deliberately. We have seen a structure involving all methyl. Let's have a structure, or this was how we started. Let this be another case where all the four are phenyl groups. Let me have a case here. This is phenyl methyl and phenyl methyl. Phenyl hydride, hydrogen, phenyl, you know, stands for the aromatic ring OH, and then maybe diols of this type, methyl hydrogen. First five, where we have already seen this, and when it's about different groups now, we'll want to know a migratory order. To begin with, let me leave you with a migratory order which is hydride more than aryl more than alkyl. Although we'll do more value addition to this order, to begin with you'll want to know an order which is hydride more than aryl more than alkyl. This is called the migratory aptitude. Just try your hand at these cases.